So Rusev wins the United States Championship from Shinsuke Nakamura on the pre-taped Christmas show on SmackDown Live. So we will first talk about it and then we will do the play-by-play review of the whole show. So I already posted a video of Rusev winning the United States Championship from a fan angle view last week when it was leaked, and everyone knows that Rusev has won the United States Championship. But we'll still talk about this first because this is obviously a title change on SmackDown Live. So the match itself was pretty good. We were just able to see the end clip, that is around 2 minute clip of the match, but the match itself was pretty good. Shinsuke Nakamura was dominating the match, but Rusev came off as a pretty good babyface, and in the end he hit the Mashka kick and Rusev is your new United States champion. So yes, Rusev Day has again arrived, and Rusev was kind of down after his breakup with Aiden English. I mean, he was down because WWE weren't pushing him, but still it's a good stuff. But I feel bad for Shinsuke Nakamura. After all, he's Shinsuke Nakamura. He was one of the top guys in New Japan Pro Wrestling and one of the top guys in NXT. He was a 2 times NXT champion, and now he's here having an awful United States title reign and just lost it on an pre-taped episode of SmackDown Live. So I kind of feel bad for Nakamura. Some people are saying that he is about to go to New Japan again and he is just going to leave WWE. I disagree. He loves surfing and he can surf in the United States because he says that the surfing is far more easier and far more fun here in the United States. And also he is getting a lot of money. Although his contract is expiring on in January 2019, so we don't know. But yeah, I think he's going to stay with WWE. But let's talk about other stuff, that is the whole review of the show. So the show started with Carmella and R-Truth coming out as Santa Claus. R-Truth was dressed as Santa Claus and Carmella was also in some Christmas dresses. So they talked about some stuff about Christmas and all that kind of the crap they talk about. I don't like R-Truth and Carmella. I mean, I like R-Truth, but it's kind of getting annoying for me. I don't like them that much as some people do. So yeah, Daniel Bryan comes out and he tears about R-Truth, saying that he should be with his family on the Christmas day and now he is here and R-Truth isn't even the real Santa Claus, and he just removes R-Truth's beard. But then R-Truth says that he is going to enter at number 30 at the Royal Rumble and he is going to beat Bryan for the championship at WrestleMania if Bryan is still the champion. Bryan got pissed and he hit R-Truth in the knee with the chop block and applied the heel hook on R-Truth. He was pissed. This Daniel Bryan stuff is going amazing. I loved it and I'm still going to love it. It is definitely one of the best gimmicks going on in WWE right now. So then we got ourselves a treat here for Christmas. We got ourselves Mustafa Ali versus Andrade Cien Almas. It was a very good match. This SmackDown Live was pretty good. It had Shinsuke Nakamura versus Rusev, a good match. And this another match was also pretty good. They had some really good exchanges. Almas also looked beautiful in the ring. The stuff was going very, very good. And Ali at last hit a DDT. That is the DDT he hits. I don't know what they call it. And then he hits the 054 on Almas for the win. So now Mustafa Ali has pinned Daniel Bryan and Andrade Cien Almas 2 weeks in a row, which is great stuff for Ali. I think it is going to be lead to a triple threat match between Mustafa Ali, Daniel Bryan and AJ Styles at Royal Rumble. Some people think Andrade Cien Almas is going to add to the mix. I don't think so, because Almas, as good as he is, and he obviously should be in the mix, but WWE is not pushing him as much. So yes, next up we got ourselves a promo from Samoa Joe that he's going to beat Jeff Hardy in today's match. But then we got ourselves a match between Gallows and Anderson and the Usos versus Sanity, that is Killian Dane and Alexander Wolf and The Bar. Another pretty good match, decent match I mean, a good finish to it. At last, the Good Brothers pinned Cesaro. So yeah, finally a push for Gallows and Anderson. Last week they came back to TV since August, and now they have pinned the champion, one half of the champion I mean. And the match itself was also pretty good. There was some good stuff because all four teams are very, very good. So yeah, next up we got ourselves the backstage segment where Ali was congratulated by other 205 Live guys, but then Shelton Benjamin comes to him and says that he is not impressed by Mustafa Ali, which I know will lead to another a match between Shelton Benjamin, Benjamin and Mustafa Ali next week, which is going to be another very good match, and Ali is going to beat Benjamin, so it will lead to Ali, an underdog, beating the legend like Shelton Benjamin. Going to be great. But yeah, let's talk about this segment. But then new Daniel Bryan comes out and beats up Mustafa Ali. So yeah, this stuff is going on. The plate is still spinning. I know, that's why I said that Mustafa Ali can get into a triple threat match against Bryan and Styles at the Royal Rumble show, which is going to be great for Mustafa Ali in 205 Live. So yes, so next up we got ourselves Shane McMahon and Miz in a segment, that is Miz TV segment, where Miz again, like every week, tries to convince Shane McMahon to join him and become a team. And finally, Shane McMahon agrees. The crowd was into it. I don't know where it will lead to, but yeah, good stuff. At least the crowd participated into it, and let's see where it leads to. Miz is going to turn face, some people are saying, and he is kind of a face already. So let's see where it leads to. So yeah, next up we got ourselves a match between Jeff Hardy and Samoa Joe. Again, a decent match. A good first match for the feud to continue. Joe, as good as a promo he is and as good as he is in making feud interesting, he loses each and every feud, and I thought he was going to lose this match too. But he won via DQ because Jeff Hardy continued to stomp on him outside, and Jeff is not as good as anymore as he was before. I mean, I know he is 40-year-old and he has been taking bumps since he was 14 years old. But yeah, still, he looks like a stick is shoved down his ass every time he moves. I personally think so. So yeah, and the match could have been better if there would have not been a 3-minute chin lock. That is Samoa Joe does it every match, man. Come on, Joe. Joe is a very good wrestler, we know it. And it's not like Joe has been aged or something like that. He was moving fluent like 2 years ago when in NXT, when he had matches with Sami Zayn and Shinsuke Nakamura and Finn Balor. So I don't know what is happening here, but at last, Jeff Hardy tries to put Joe through a table, but then Joe chokes him out with a coquina clutch, and then looks at the camera with the intensity that he always does, which looks amazing, by the way. So next up we got ourselves the main event of the show, which we already talked about. At last we got a weird segment. So what happened was Vince McMahon was backstage with AJ Styles, and he was working up AJ, saying that he doesn't know who AJ Styles is, and AJ was like, you don't know who AJ Styles is? This is the house that AJ Styles built and stuff like that. And then Vince McMahon continued to push the buttons of AJ and says some offensive stuff for AJ Styles, because AJ is a hothead, we know. I mean, this character work comes partially, but WWE is not good for consistent gimmicks and storylines. But yeah, still they somehow managed to bring that stuff up, that AJ is a hothead in some of his feuds. So yeah, Vince McMahon slapped AJ Styles. AJ Styles punched him back hard as nails, and Vince McMahon taking bumps at the age of 73 while Brock Lesnar is still there. And I like Brock Lesnar, by the way. So yeah, kind of weird stuff, considering AJ Styles definitely didn't turn heel and it was just a segment. I don't know, maybe Vince McMahon is a face and he is trying to get AJ Styles all warmed up to face Daniel Bryan and stuff. Maybe Vince McMahon will become the manager of AJ Styles. We don't know. I don't think that will happen though. So yeah, Becky. So this was my SmackDown Live review of the show. Becky Lynch, Charlotte and Asuka were not on the show. I mean, there was no participation of women on the show except for Carmella was there and Lana was there, and their stuff was not important or anything. So yeah, no women on the show, but still a very good show. I like the new Daniel Bryan stuff. I like the Mustafa Ali vs Andrade match. I like the Rusev vs Nakamura match. And the match between Joe and Hardy and the tag team match was also decent. So yeah, and Miz and Shane are leading to something new. Let's see what happens in that and where it leads to. And AJ Styles and McMahon are onto something, we don't know. So let's see what happens in the upcoming weeks of 2019. Thank you and have a cheerful day. So Rusev.